Today we're going to be looking at the basics of fractions. We're going to be looking at just adding and subtracting. But before we get into that, we need to get a little bit of the vocabulary so that we know what we're doing when I'm using, you know, this terminology with fractions. So whenever we're looking at a fraction, let's say we have a fraction like 2/5, the top number here is called our numerator. The number down at the bottom is the denominator. The way that I help students to remember this is the denominator is down in the bottom. So numerator then, process of elimination, would be the top number then. So we will be using this vocab as we're going through this. So let's make sure that we remember this. I would definitely add this to my notes if I were you guys, because I'm going to be using this terminology for both the adding and subtracting video and the multiplication and division video, because it's part of our steps for doing some of these problems. So let's say that I want to add two fractions together. I'll stick with the 2/5 that I just used. And let's say I want to add it to 1/2. Whenever we are adding or subtracting, and both of these steps are the same, so in your notes over here, I'm going to make a column for our steps. And these are the steps that we're going to use when adding or subtracting fractions, because the process for both of these is just about identical. The first thing that you need to do whenever you're adding or subtracting fractions is to find a common denominator. Again, these steps I would put into my notes. If you have these steps and you understand what it's telling you to do, then you're going to be able to just follow them, and I'll walk you right through exactly what you're doing. So in this problem here, my denominators, again, which are my bottom numbers, they are not the same. Common meaning the same. I need my fractions to have the same denominator. So what I have to do is I have to look at my two denominators, which are 5 and 2, and I have to decide what number can I get them both to using multiplication. So I think to myself, right, 5, 2, what can I get those to? And the answer to that is 10. I can turn both of these fractions into denominators of 10 by, so for the first one, I would need to multiply it by 2. Okay, well, whatever I do to my denominator, I also have to do to my numerator. So I'm going to multiply my denominator by 2. I need to multiply the numerator by 2 as well. So 2 times 2 is going to give me 4/10. And if you wanted to make sure that you did this correctly, does 4/10 reduce back to 2/5? And it does. So you know we're not really changing the fraction, we're just making the numbers larger. Okay. Same thing over here. How did I get from 2 to 10? Well, I did that by multiplying by 5. So again, what I do to my denominator, I have to do to my numerator. So 5 over 10, just to double check. All right, that reduces to 1/2. I know that I've got my common denominator correctly. From here then, now that I have the common denominators, and since we're doing this for both adding and subtracting, I'm going to write both of those here. I'm going to add or subtract. I'm going to actually add in here your numerators. The numerators get added together, so 4 plus 5 is 9. And I said, notice I said only adding the numerators. Your denominators, once you find that common denominator and they're both the same thing, it stays. The denominators do not get added together, or when we do a subtraction problem in a minute, they do not get subtracted. Only the numerators either add together or subtract together. 9/10. All right, is where I'm at now. Step 3, and this sometimes applies, sometimes it doesn't. You're going to reduce your fraction or convert it to a mixed number. If that fraction were improper, meaning your numerator is larger than your denominator, you would need to turn it into a mixed number. We don't have that here. 9/10, our numerator is smaller than our denominator, so Step 3 doesn't apply because it doesn't need to be a mixed number, nor can 9 over 10 be reduced. So this then would be my answer to 2/5 plus 1/2. Okay? So with that being said, then we're going to follow these same steps. Hopefully you have all of these in your notes, because you're going to notice we follow the same 3 steps then when we go to our subtraction problem, which we're going to do right now. So let's say that we had 7/8 minus 2/3. Again, if you think about the steps that we had over here and that you hopefully put in your notebook, first thing we want to do is we need to find that common denominator. So I'm going to set up my two fractions with a subtraction in between. And from there, I'm going to think, all right, 8, 3. What number can I get both of those to? And that is going to be 24. In order to get 8 to 24, I would need to multiply both of these by 3. To get from 3 to 24, I needed to multiply those by 8. So again, I'm just showing what I need to multiply here, because that's also then going to give me my numerator, because I need to multiply by the same number. 3 times 7 is 21. 2 times 8 is 16. So step one, we found that common denominator. Step two then was to add or subtract. Well, in this problem, obviously, you can see that it's a subtraction. So again, I'm going to add or subtract the numerators. So here I'm going to subtract this. 21 minus 16 is 5. 5 over 24 then becomes my answer, because again, if I try step three, 5 over 24 cannot be reduced. And my numerator is smaller than my denominator, so again, it's not an improper fraction, which means I don't have to convert it to a mixed number. This is my final answer. All right, so I've showed you two problems now. From here, I'm gonna give you guys two problems to try on your own and see if you can do these without me. I know I didn't show you any of the problems that show reducing or converting a fraction to a mixed number, but you already know how to do both of those. So that third step should be what we've practiced the last couple of days, so you shouldn't really need me to show that. It's just combining the two skills that we've looked at. So first problem that I'm gonna give you, 6/8 plus 1/10. Your next problem is going to be 7/5 minus 2/3. So at this point, pause the video, do these problems, then unpause the video and I'll show you all of the work along with the answers to see, so that way you can see how you did. Okay, now that you've unpaused, you can see the answers here. For the first one, we get 68 over 80. And like I said, one of these is gonna incorporate reduction. So both of these numerators and denominators can be divisible by 4. So that's gonna reduce to 17 over 20. And then your last one, straightforward, can't be reduced. So find that common denominator, subtract, and you're gonna get 11 15ths. Okay, hopefully this video was helpful. What I would like you to do for your homework assignment, now that you have these two done, is to write down any questions that you might have and bring them to class tomorrow. That way we can address those and you guys will be all good with adding and subtracting fractions. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.